All right, I gotta start light today before I go on to the heavier stones. Oh, good warm up. What's up, everybody? Today's primary focus, squats. I'm gonna work up to about 705 pounds for a set of anywhere between 3 to 2, whatever it might be. The thing is, I haven't squatted above 5. I really haven't squatted heavy for a while now. I've done a lot of repetitions with the 500 pound range, but it shouldn't be a problem. Squatting heavy comes easy when I choose to do it. The 705 for 13 is my personal best.
You're not using the box like Halfthor was trading on his Instagram?
Yeah, I'm gonna use the box next week. Today I just want to get the feel for the weight, and I think the boxes are easy. There's no real skill, not that much of a skill curve to the box. I think the boxes are difficult for tighter lifters, because the thing is, they set those boxes up so that way you have to squat right to parallel, and I notice a lot of strongmen squat slightly above parallel, which is what messes them up when it comes down to using the boxes. So for me, that's not an issue.
Who's this kid right here?
This is Nate.
Nate, remember him?
He's got Jordans on now. He's learning.
Take your advice.
Look at that. Oh my God, he's gonna go so fast.
So this is your normal mobility training right here?
I've changed it up a little bit. I've noticed my torso has been getting stiff. So I'm doing the, just like kind of the world's greatest stretch. I do repetitions with it just to kind of warm up my torso and stretch out my hip flexors. Activate my stabilizers, my adductors, and abductors. Because thing is, if you really focus on it, you have to keep your adductors tight in order to not allow your knee to flare out. So I'm really trying to keep my foot perfectly planted on the floor while doing this stretch and rotation.
That looks pretty, brother!
What are you working at today?
I don't know. What are you listening to?
You know what a dying old lady sounds like? Losing her cat. That's why I like. Are you gonna strap up today?
You bet. I'm gonna gear up. Hopefully get a squat suit on if I can still fit into it. I'm a little nervous about that. I should have probably ordered a new one.
More weight.
More weight.
Lindsay!
They're heavy though.
Go, 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 go. Come on, Lindsay. There you go. Who's the fell? Who's the fell? Who's the fell? Press. Find the hole. Nice.
I'm just rolling up my adductors and hamstrings a little bit before these squats. They're feeling a little tense today. Just want to make sure that those guys are loose and ready. It helps, basically just helps pump some blood in. If you imagine muscles like a sponge, you squeeze all this, you know, all the juicy stuff out of the sponge, then you release it, it'll super compensate and flush a lot more juicy stuff back in.
Thank you.
So I'm suiting up because likely in the contest we're going to suit up. And I need to practice the tension of the suit and also make sure that the suit still fits me. This is a legendary suit worn by Odd Haugen himself through all of his epic contests. He handed it down to me and they don't make them like this anymore. This really is a special suit. I've not encountered this kind of material in other suits. It's really tight.
100% Norwegian.
Yeah. I can't get them around my butt, Romark. The butt's too big.
How come you're not using ollie shoes?
I don't like ollie shoes for squatting. They put too much of the pressure anteriorly. They load up my knees too much versus I want all the pressure to go back into my heels and my posterior. And I have good ankle flexibility, so I don't need those shoes.
It gives you an extra bump at the bottom, but I think you have a pretty good drive off the floor. And maybe the difference with the sports car, by the way.
So what are you working up to?
705 there.
705. How does a suit feel versus?
Suit's crazy.
Yeah, it's like
what
nothing.
A different feel, yeah.
You didn't even know you were going parallel, huh?
I felt like I was not going deep enough.
Well, how old were you when you competed your first World Strongest Man?
51.
51 years old?
Your
first one, yeah.
First World Strongest Man.
Yeah.
Dang.
Wow.
56 in my last. I did Masters Worlds in my 60s. Mm. My first Masters World when I was 61. Got third.
Double my age when he retired from World's Strongest Man. Double. I said my back's feeling a little funky today, so I hope I could brace better this next set.
Nice speed.
I remember why I had to stop at 13 at Worlds. It wasn't the strength. I can't breathe in this thing.
Come on, let's go.
Film landscape.
Center.
Film landscape and take pictures. This way, right here. I want this whole rack. You're gonna send it to me.
Good. Come on. Good. Good. Good.
Four, let's go.
Come on, let's go. Good.
Good, come on.
Way deep.
Good. Good job. Thank you, Preston.
Grab his knees.
Was that five?
Six.
Every single one of them was like power left.
Yeah. Every one of them was like five. Yeah. Yeah.
So, do you take pictures?
No.
Yeah, it's for cover photo. Those are good reps.
Good. Great place to be.
Yeah. Hey, look at his blood right here.
Yeah.
Good job, man.
When you get these wraps off?
Just pull them up, pull them down.
No worries, Chris. Yes, thank you.
Good job. What's next?
So
you put on Olympic shoes for stones?
Yes. Yes, because for stones, I like to be more anteriorly loaded because I do the rock and I go right back onto my toes. So it gets me a much better explosivity going forward.
We're going to do a different technique of gearing up. In the last weeks, you've been doing no tacky.
No tacky, just chalk.
And then I
saw Novikov doing it with duct tape. And I've used medical tape before, but I want to see what duct tape feels like, because medical tape kind of is flimsy. And I feel it slip a lot. In the hot weather of Florida, I want something that really sticks to my form. Wow, tacky makes it a lot easier.
So, do you use the Ode Haugen tacky, or do you use a spider tacky?
Spider tacky all the way.
Is it better? What is it, Ode?
Crap tacky.
You just made Ode mad.
I'll put it back.
You just made Ode mad.
What the fuck kind of tacky do you use?
Elite.
Ew.
Much better.
Water!
What can you use yourself?
Water! I got tacky on my hand, water.
Alright, let's see this. Open the mouth.
Do you want more water?
A little bit more.
Just a little?
Uh-huh.
Are you going to give me a down signal?
Perfect. We're going to be practicing that in Worlds.
Did you guys put baby powder under there?
Yeah.
So it doesn't hurt when you
rub it on? Who the hell gives a shit if it hurts?
I would.
Yeah, but no.
And why are you choosing to use duct tape as opposed to like athletic tape?
Because Novikov did it.
Oh yeah, one more thing. Death Star.
Death Star it is.
Death Star.
Why is this called the Death Star?
It looks like one. Look at that little.
There's another side.
There's one on the other side, it looks. Yeah, there we go. Death Star.
Let's go, baby.
Yep, come on. Okay, I'm going home. I'm gonna rest and do a set. My theory is that spider tacky is great under 75 degrees. Above 75 Fahrenheit, you need elite. Heavy weather, hot weather.
Let's go.
Go. One, count
two,
up.
Three, four, five.
Nice. Okay.
Let's go. One, two, three.
Hey, where's Phil today?
I don't know, man. He might be sick or something.
Well then, who's gonna clean up all this chalk that's falling on the floor?
Martin, you ready?
Ready?
That was too easy.
Yeah, well, that was warm up.
Competitive, ready? Go!
Come on.
Quick feet, come on, baby.
Stay down there.
There it is. Stay down.
Stay down there, it's perfect.
Keep going.
Come on,
stay down.
Come on.
Use your arm.
Let's go.
Perfect, good job.
Touch the door. Nice.
I hold on to the beginning bit.
Oh.
So, and I let out a little bit, so that it is the same way as the other.
That was perfect.
Because otherwise, you'll
it's just one, rocket forward.
Yeah, it's one resistance. This way, it'll become hard, and easier. Just like you in a real truck.
Good news, everybody. Old Haugen, the legendary Old Haugen, is coming to World's Strongest Man. He's been my mentor, coach, and idol throughout the years. A strong man I've aspired to be like, and he's coming along. So very excited.
And I'm only coaching winners, so he's gonna win.
Tomorrow, Monday, we're gonna be doing overhead practice. Maybe a medley carry medley as well. We'll see how the energy is. Definitely overhead tomorrow. Axle focused, likely. So, originally gonna have Bradley Martin over here. We're gonna do a podcast, then get to a workout. But we never really specified on where we're meeting. So, when 1 o'clock rolled around, I texted him asking him for his ETA, and he replied back, "I'm here." A moment went by, and he said, "At Zoo Culture." And then I realized, oh my gosh, he's waiting for me at his gym. I'm waiting for him at my gym. Oh man, a bunch of airheads. So today I'm just gonna, pretty exhausted. So I'm just gonna work on my axle clean press, maybe some dumbbell clean presses.
What's wrong?
Everything hurts.
See how high he gets it.
Pain. Head to toe. It's like Big Z said, strong man is pain. I wonder if I could pull it that high.
Yeah. Why do you wrap your thumbs around the bar, so like hugging the bar?
I was trying both. So I was trying to see which one sits better. I think thumbless on an axle especially allows me to really sit the bar on my collarbone, which helps me drive my body into the weight more. So I'll see which one works better. Well, on the positive note, Bradley didn't come in and see me being a complete wuss of a disaster today, so that's good.
What's working so today?
Dude, I'm telling you, like, I want to work up to my weight, but right now just, I'm in pain. I might have to call out. I'm gonna work a little bit more. We'll see. I will see. I mean, worst case, thank you, Phil, but that has a place in time. He threw me. Which you could buy off of Juji Mufu's website. Really good smelling salts, probably the best. They make me want to puke every time, but they make me get PRs.
Let's go, buddy.
Yes. Yeah. There you go.
Oh, he had a belly.
Oh, Jesus. At this point, it's really mental. I'm just not committed to it.
I'm not committing it to you. Come on. There it is, good. What do you want to create from this workout? Just practicing the cleans?
I don't know, dude. I don't know. I might just
call it a day.
I don't know.
Hey, Zeus, we miss you. Hi.
Remember? Before you went to Worlds?
Yeah.
And in one session you went from you fucking couldn't do 300 pounds to doing 400 pounds.
That's right.
Yeah. It's one of those things that if you end up doing it all the time, it like kind of loosen the timing, yeah.
Okay, let's do it. I'm having a hard time popping it from here.
Yeah, I see you.
Yeah.
You should be able to get there, and then you get the
yeah. I think it's because I'm afraid of hurting my knee. So it's like I just go like this instead of like dropping under it.
So it's something like that.
So I'm trying to like purely use my hips instead of
pumping my knees. Have you ever dealt with this product? With this problem, you can just sue it. From the producers that brought you and the lawyers that sued people for mesothelioma. Now you can also sue your friends.
Keeps happening like that.
I've been there. You were in the right position, but I think you're just kind of jumping it up instead of. You gotta let go. You gotta kind of let go of the thing.
Let go and catch it?
Yeah. It's exactly the same as. Using that one, but it has to, you know, it bounced. But I kept doing what he's doing. I just like popping, you know, nothing happened. And anytime I touched it, I couldn't do it. It was like it mentally got turned off.
Like a glitch.
No, I know, you'll get it. But I broke my leg and Brianna come running out there to doctor me. This!
That's what I mean, it's that drop that you just did that I'm avoiding.
Yeah, you're doing this!
Yeah, but I'm avoiding, that's what I'm telling you, I'm avoiding that drop.
So like, the drop that isn't what usually hurts the knee, the usually knee, like, you hurt the knee is this part, the first part.
It's the drop part, it hurts.
Yeah.
I'll try.
Right, you gotta drop. You gotta leave it right there in that same.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be good. You go up and you can come underneath it.
It's still bad though.
It's really stiff.
Yeah.
It's not a deep drop. You're like muscling it up.
But you're tight.
I think it's worth doing right because you have so much energy. The one you were doing it when you were doing the series, you're wasting so much energy because you're just jumping it up and you're rolling it through.
Okay,
here we go.
Stay very nice and comfortable when you have it up on the chest. Think light.
Frustrated.
Yo, teams, what's up? Teams, all you lightweight body guys. Here we go. Up. Okay. You go switch.
There.
Good pop.
Nice.
Again.
Let's see,
or
your legs are really short. Are you
starting really wide? I don't think so.
My hands that wide. Make sure your legs are in lock, so you have room to move out. That way you don't need to bend as much.
Okay. You can try that. Hi. So today didn't go that great. I came in here with the intention to master my axle clean and jerk. But just, you know, yesterday was a really intense workout day. I thought I'd at least be able to do axle, but between my left knee, my back, which rarely hurts, really rare that my back hurts, but I think because my axle clean has not been all that clean, my back's taken the brunt for the force. And of course, my elbow hurts too, so I need to recover. Hopefully Wednesday or Thursday, I'll be ready to go again for an intense workout and get this axle down, master it.